Did Ezra and Thrawn strike a deal? Episode 6 of Ahsoka is out, and while I really love the episode, there's something I just cannot stop thinking about, and it's really why I wanted to make this video today. Why is Ezra able to just roam the planet of Peridia without any issues? I mean, surely Thrawn and the Night Sisters would be hunting him. Well, after breaking a few things down, I think this could mean something pretty big. Let's get right into it. After Thrawn finds out that Sabine's a prisoner, they start to have a conversation about Ezra, and that all she wanted to do was see him. Thrawn tells her that they have Ezra's last whereabouts and that he'd help her find him. But what's his angle here? I mean, Thrawn has been here for about 10 years at this point. If he wanted to go after Ezra, surely he would have by now. So it's like there's no motivation for him to have Ezra captured. And clearly he knows where Ezra is if they have some sort of intel on him. So this is where things get interesting. I don't think Thrawn cares about Ezra at this point, which is pretty obvious, right? But the reason for this is because I believe Ezra and Thrawn struck a deal. Say Ezra were to try and fight up against Thrawn and his army here, right? Well, clearly he'd lose. He'd have no chance, he'd be outnumbered, and on top of it, with the Night Sisters involved, it would be impossible for him. So what I see here is a win-win scenario for both of them. Thrawn lets Ezra off the hook and lets him live in exchange for blood. Now you may ask, well, why blood? Well, what if these new Night Troopers are actually clones of Ezra enhanced with Night Sister magic? I know it sounds like a lot, but really think about it here. If Thrawn wanted Ezra dead, he would be by now. If Thrawn wanted to hunt Ezra by now, he would have by now. But if you've read the novels or even watched Rebels, you'll know that Thrawn is one to always honor a deal. So this is what's fascinating here. These Night Troopers are clearly not Stormtroopers anymore. I mean, if so, then they just use the name Stormtroopers, right? But under those helmets, these could be Force-sensitive beings, just like Marok was. And if you haven't seen it yet, I did make a video about this around episode 4 where I kind of predicted around the same thing. But anyways, we know in The Mandalorian, that's why Moff Gideon was so obsessed with Grogu. He wanted to make Force-sensitive clones of himself to create an unstoppable army. And well, what if that's the same here? A combination of Ezra's DNA mixed with Night Sister magic. I mean, who knows what could happen out of that? Keep in mind, Thrawn has been here for 10 years. And not only that, but he has some of the most powerful beings by his side. I mean, we could only imagine what he's been able to build throughout these years. So I really think this theory would make perfect sense. I do think that we'll get a lot of our answers next episode, and for the remainder of the season, I really don't think we'll be leaving Peridia. It seems like a lot is building up on that planet, and with the direction that Baylan Skoll's character is heading, I really think we have some cool stuff on the way. I mean, just being able to see that there's something calling to him on this planet is extremely interesting to me. Clearly, he has a larger goal on Peridia, something way larger than finding Thrawn, and it must be a pretty big deal if he says even the Night Sisters are afraid of this power. A lot of fans are speculating that it could be Abeloth, the Yuuzhan Vong, and I've even seen some think it could be Darth Bane calling to him. But regardless, I think Dave Filoni is setting up something really cool here. I mean, the lore in episode 6 was just great, and I think it's only going to get better from here with only 2 episodes left. But anyways, what do you think? Do you agree with the theory that Thrawn and Ezra struck a deal and that's why they're not actively hunting Ezra? Or do you think something else? Let me know in the comments below. Thanks for watching and may the Force be with you, always.